long boxes.
Getting
should
ready
be on,
for
I'll
the
take
team
it
limited meeting for Team CFB Fire and Team Mutiny.
Whatever. Setting up the white card.
Everyone. Alright, so essentially these are all tops, like cards I'm actively happy to first pick. These are going to be like good commons slash good uncommons that draw me into a color. They extend down to here. These are sort of your filler slash still solid playables where I'm going to be taking these between 4th through 7th, about 8th. Be pretty happy about it. If I get them after that, that's a sign for me the color's open. If I take it before that, I'm not really pleased, but they're still going to go to my deck. I'm still going to be happy with them. These are all like replacement fillery cards where I don't have them really separated out in a different pile. Most of the white cards end up there for me besides about the top like 6 or 7 cards. I think you can spread those into a separate pile if you want to. And then the bottom 3 cards are cards I absolutely do not ever want to put in my deck under almost any normal circumstance. I'm going to have more strict sort of feelings about this than most other people. When I say a card is unplayable and it ends up in my deck, I'm going to be actively very unhappy. Whereas I know some of you are going to be like, yeah, I'll put that guy in my deck. No, I will absolutely not put that card in my deck. I would rather play a 17th land or something. That's how I feel about some of these cards. Now, I'm going to be strictly wrong about some of those things. Go ahead.
I didn't mean to cut you off. There are a few things that I think are too low here. Specifically, Aerial Modification, Felidar Guardian, and possibly Harpooner. But I'm not sure about Harpooner. But I think that, like, these cards are a lot better than these cards.
I agree.
Guardian, like, triggers all your revolts and stuff. And Aerial Modification has been, like, quite good for me. If my deck has, like, 2 big vehicles and then just, like, it's fine to just backdoor put it on a guy to get the last 5 points in or whatever.
So do we think these need to end up here? Do they end up here? I've never gotten to cast this card.
I think, like, here.
Well, I've not found this card to be very good. I found this to be about as good as this guy, where it's like a random body that also has.
I don't like this guy.
That card's disappointed me a lot.
Yeah, I think this guy's bad, but I think that Felidar Guardian's like very good in some decks, and you know, it's fine. Like, it's a 1/4 for 4 that does something a lot of the time, and sometimes it does something quite good. I'm interested in other people's thoughts on the Harpooner.
It does not seem very good to me. Like, it's. It's pretty hard to trigger that revolt just, like, incidentally. I mean, obviously you could trigger it, but, like, also have, like, you trade and have a tapped guy. It doesn't really come up that often. I mean, and if you're only playing it as a Grey Ogre, that's just not a card. So, yeah, I've not been super impressed. Maybe I'm supposed to be playing it with, like, the flicker card from the first set. And
right, it's definitely one that gains a lot of value if you're blinking it.
But, like, are those white decks good in this format? Like, if you're white and you don't have flyers and you just have a bunch of, you know, blank stuff and harpooners, like, is that a deck you want to draft?
I have tried it and done poorly with it.
Okay. I do think those decks are not very good, so I also don't think Harpooner is a very good card in this format.
Okay, I'm down with leaving Harpooner not higher.
So, would you guys put him back into the Aerial Modification pile, or do you think he's as far back as the Restoration Specialist? I still think the card is high enough upside that it still belongs in at least this pile.
I agree.
Yeah, it's at least as good as, like, Felidar Guardian or whatever. Like, it's a card you can still put into your aggressive deck. It's not miserable, and you might sometimes just blow people out. Like, if you're racing, like, it's a pretty good card, right?
Yep.
They're going to block your guy, and then you're going to eat their biggest guy.
Yeah, I don't mean to say I think it's unplayable or anything, but I think it's, like, just, it looks like you should pick it high, and I don't think that's true, like, when you first see the set or whatever.
Yeah, I agree. But I think the deck that really uses it doesn't exist, but...
I also think that these two are not separate categories.
Do you, like, disagree that these two are in the same category, though?
I think that this is a lot better than that.
See, I find them on about the same tier, but I end up white-red a lot, where I want my guys tapped.
One of them is Progenitus, and the other one isn't, so...
There's also Progenitus, right. Argument.
I mean, like, I understand, like, it's the best 2-drop and the best 5-drop. You want more 2-drops than you want 5-drops. But there are, like, I think that this is closer in power level to not the other white 2-drops, but the other, like, red, other color 2-drops. Whereas this is better than, like, you know, whatever your second color is, that's better than the flyer that it offers, with the closest alternative being the green one.
Certainly an effect you need, because there's less Inspired Charges running around also.
I think the 3-1 is more replaceable than...
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Yeah. Like, the, like, early, I can understand, like, prioritizing the 3-1 to make sure that your, like, curve is, like, that your deck's functional, that your curve works and stuff, but, like, Eagle is really outstanding. Like, if I know that my curve is solid in pack two, I want Eagle over, like, the other guy.
The one thing is that, like, I've definitely cut Eagle a bunch. Like, I've had too many 5-drops. I never have too many 2-drops. That's why I just think it's not close early. Like, you basically always kind of take...
There aren't a lot of 5-drops, though. Like, I don't know how you end up with so many, because there aren't a lot.
You wouldn't play all 3 Eagles?
But I mean, there's not a lot of competition. Unless you're white green and you're trying to play Calvary, there just aren't a lot of other good ones.
Yeah, I think you have to be green light to have 2 power drops. Have you had it happen?
White red, like the 4-5 does, I'm just not as good, but he's still good.
Yeah, but you don't cut Eagle then.
I'm not cutting Eagle, but I'd rather have a 3-1
sure.
Than play a 4-5.
Any other qualms before we move on to blue?
Is conviction really that high?
I think conviction is very important, yeah. There's just like a lot of ground racing, starts crewing your guys, you can move it around then to another guy that can actually get a profitable attack in. Pairs well into green, bigger monsters, pairs well into red with evasive creatures, first strike, slash, menace.
It's also not that high. It's worth noting that the...
I think this is probably closer to the 8th pick end of this category than the...
Again, a little lower because of redundancy.
Well, that whole stack is not stuff you're picking very high.
Right, basically. But is it the worst card in that? Like, to me, it seems like the worst card in that stack.
Yes, it is the worst card in that stack to me.
Yeah, I think it's better than the 5-man enchantment.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's better than the 5-man enchantment. I think it's better than Guardian.
Oh, wow.
Probably think it's better than Windrake.
Yeah, I mean, basically, I think the kind of problem people have with that is they look at it like a normal aura, but you can obviously just play it with an extra mana up. And also just... the way the white decks play out, like often you're like white red and you have like high power, low toughness guys, so it helps you push through in addition to obviously their bolt stuff.
Yeah. And so you would take it in any white deck? Like, is there a particular one that fits better into?
I mean, it's probably not as good in like white green because you have big guys anyway.
Right.
But.
Although white green is the revolt deck.
So yeah, maybe it is.
Well, if you're using for revolt stuff and the only really good white deck is red white, what revolt do you really have?
If you are green white, like he said, like do you put it in a green white deck? So it doesn't matter if you don't like green white. Like once you're in green white, you need to.
No. You guys are saying that the conviction is good because it pushes damage through, which I agree with, and it also like triggers your revolt. But if the only really good white deck is red white, there is no revolt.
Well, I mean, you can still have this guy.
You can be other decks. Sure. Like you're not always the exact deck you want to be.
Yeah. Like, you could be white-black and have, like, the black -3/-3 guy.
Sure, but sure.
You can also just open a Gear Hulk and then move into white.
Sure.
Don't forget SRAM.
Well, yeah, obviously pick the card higher if you have SRAM.
Yeah, with SRAM, I would take a Battle Slice though.
I'd like to point out that I feel like a lot of other people or teams or just groups in general are very down on this card, so I don't think you need to, like, you know, see it and take it over, like... something else just because you're going to get one pretty late. Like everybody was just like laughing at it when I was talking and you know, just asking them about various cards, and I had a conviction in my deck. They're like, is that card playable? Like I had a lot of people come up to me and ask me that.
Cool.
Okay, can we take a picture of this before we go?
I got it already.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, I have something like this laid out to start.
My first question is about Bastification Array. Like, I don't think that... Like, I could just be way off on this, but, like, I would never take that over, like, a Treasure Keeper.
I think they're the same group. Yeah, I was surprised by those being in different categories.
Yeah, I think they're the same.
So, I have this over this mostly because of the improvised decks, and I think the improvised decks, you just drastically need a 1, and I want to play so few lands in those decks that having more 1s allows it to count as just a Colossus Mock so frequently, and that I can get good 4-drops in those decks just by playing 6-mana improvised guys.
It's way less replaceable.
Yes.
I can't comment on that. My improvised decks don't work.
So I think while overall these cards end up more like this probably for the average deck, I think early I'm much more likely to take the 1-mana card as it just plays more like a mana rock. I'm also much more biased to playing black-red where I don't want to put a 4-mana 3/3 into my deck. I will put this card in my deck and be so stoked to have it.
So I mean, if the biggest thing is about you know just having you know a mana rock early, like I think that part of it is incredibly replaceable just from all the implements. Like you know, yeah, they're not great or whatever, but
there's also
I
don't know, it's just
yes. So yeah, I get that it does things, but I mean, I'm not sure like how often I'm going to be wanting to you know when it gets to that point in the game. Sure, it's great if you don't need to use your mana to be able to afford to tap something, but I don't know. I could just be wrong, but I haven't been that like you know blown away by it. But it could just be the different decks that I'm drafting, and maybe I just don't have enough experience. But I'm pretty. I don't know if I'm the lone person who thinks that pacification array is like so much higher than all the rest of the artifacts in here. Like, that's just my input on that.
Jerry?
Pacification Raid does something that is much different than many of the other cards in the format. That's why I think, like, it moves up, in my opinion. Rather, like, Treasure Keeper is obviously very good. It is standing well and all that stuff, but it's like, it is more replaceable than that card.
Yeah, for multiple different reasons. Yeah. Also, with, like, implements, it's not, like, redundancy with implements. It's like they get better as you have more and more.
Also, like, also, from what I've seen, the problem with Improvised Decks fails when you start put a bunch of like subpar cards in your deck to make your Improvised stuff work. If you have a great card and don't have to play like a very medium implement, that's much better. That's not like close to equivalent. Also, piggybacking off what Jerry said, I have, as I, like, Pacification Raid is impressed every time I played it, and I keep finding more good interactions for it. It makes, like, the White FTK better. It makes Ice Over a much better card. There's, like, a lot of work that it does.
Yeah, I started out thinking it was awesome, and then it's gotten better every time I've played with it.
Yeah, I'm good with Pacification Raid over Treasure Keeper. How do people feel about this thing specifically compared to Mobile Garrison? Any thoughts?
I like Garrison better. I have not really been impressed by the dragster, and I don't think Garrison's like great or anything, but I do like sometimes you randomly just have that like red white idiot and like two things can't block now or whatever, like it
double looting or
sometimes any tap trigger basically.
Yeah, to say where these are laid out, this would be like the seventh pick category, and then these are cards I'm not happy playing, and then these are just try not to ever put in your deck.
Oh, but really? They're an improvise. I've had good experiences with this.
Not had a good experience with that guy, yeah.
Also, I think these are playable.
I thought this card was bad, and it was, like, fine or better every time I put it in my deck. Like, it keeps impressing.
Yeah.
But not being great, but, like, by not being bad.
Like, okay, it's yet to make the cut for me.
Okay, well, I think if
that
you play
probably
with it,
the feelings why I don't have it in this category, where it's, like, bad but playable, like, replacement level.
Yeah, I think it's totally playable.
And you think this is also the bad but replacement level area?
Yeah.
I just have a big struggle getting to the 7 activated cost to ever turn it from being a mox like this card into what this card does, which actually just uses its activated ability very frequently.
So yeah, the 3-1 ends up in my deck a decent amount. As I mean, it's just like curve filler, but like the... Yeah, exactly. It crews that, and it's an artifact for Improvise. Like, and it just has these like two extra abilities that like aren't on the card, basically. So like if you're drafting like a red-white deck and you have Crusher, then like... you want that card if you're like versus like a, you know, a guy with two power or whatever, because you want to be able to crew that.
Yeah,
so.
Like I want that over like the guy that throws artifacts at them because it can crew my characters.
So double blocking comes up not in free.
Yeah, so my
do you
issue.
Think it's actually as high as this then?
No.
I mean, no. I don't mean to overstate. Like, it's not like.
It's just.
Like, I would replace it with many other cards if I could, but like, it makes my deck a decent amount because it does things that my deck will need.
Yeah, my issue with that card was just. I only played it once, and I was like, never again.
Did
just,
you get Puzzle
Knight? No, I didn't get Puzzle Knight. It was just like, the body was totally irrelevant. I didn't have any vehicles. So just like a 3-mana 3-1 that just couldn't get through anything. It just like didn't do anything for me. Also, if you're looking to like improvise, a lot of times you want to improvise into like Brawler, and this doesn't even help you ramp into the Brawler turn 3. So maybe if you're like, you know, drafting like the bigger blue or black cards, it's better. But for me, it's been pretty disappointing. I played it once. It was terrible. I've had it played against me a couple of times. It was also very bad, but that's my limit.
I'd be very unlikely to play in a deck with fewer than two Crushers.
Okay, fair.
Do people agree with Servo Schematic being that high?
I don't know. I mean, I never end up in those decks, and I don't really pick that card that high because it's really only good if you're trying to go hard at Improvise. But I have seen it be good in decks that are going hard at Improvise.
I think it and the 2-3 should be lower. I'm just they're definitely not the same category as the two vehicles.
Yeah,
I would agree.
I agree. I think it's just like a combo card. Like it's really good in some decks and really bad in everything else.
Yeah, I can't imagine picking it high because it's not like it's just like, oh, this goes in every deck. It's an artifact. Yeah. Like it just does nothing in some decks.
So the Crusher is just a tier ahead of all three of these cards.
I think Dreadnought's higher than that.
Dreadnought is higher than all the cards you have in that category.
Like it's really good in red white or red black with the encounter.
Isn't the Dreadnought better than Crusher in the decks where you won both of those? Or like where you won Crusher? I guess you won Crusher.
I assume so.
I can see the Dreadnought being better than Crusher. It's like sometimes just
I think
just decks
better than Crusher.
The Improvise.
Has effective casting cost of 0. Crusher takes a turn back. That's really it.
Yeah. So you guys all have this here.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to be picking the card here.
Actually, no, I have it here. I have it with math.
Yeah, I would have
it
with
math personally. Because, you know, in like a war
for both and what's your in vehicles for it.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. So I was trying to think of I don't think I would ever take like cotton brights over that. So as long as like this.
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
Just keeps going down.
It's not good.
It's not great.
That seems fun.
Yeah.
I hope everyone knows that any enchantment that exists to answer a creature just always knock down a category if you're trying to figure out my rankings.
Sure.
It's always what I'm sorry.
He means not Oblivion, though.
Right. Yeah, if you put any aura that answers a creature, just knock it down a category if you're trying to figure out how I think about it.
Control magic.
I mean, I do think... I do think that kind of card got better in this format than the last one. There's less bouncing stuff.
But so that one in particular is embarrassing because of vehicles.
Sure. I mean, if you're an aggressive deck and it removes their blocker, it's still like a fine card.
I think that it's awkward to put that guy over Treasure Keeper, unless you think back one pick one you're taking it over Treasure Keeper.
I am. I've not had great experiences with Treasure Keeper.
Is blue an actual vehicle color?
No.
So we should probably move those down a couple notches.
Yep.
Right?
That's a good point.
I was just as moving further down, but
I think that it can be like I think it's pretty high in blue red because it. Like, powers your improvisers, and your improvisers are good at creating it. Yeah, I would actually guess that card's really good in blue-red.
Have people had good experiences with the Lincoln Raiders? This one?
Yes.
The 4th round?
Yes.
It's been very good.
Telling 7-5 about where it is, possibly moving it up.
Is it not better than Goodwin Drake?
Than Goodwin Drake. What's Goodwin Drake?
He's asking if this is a higher category than this. And I'm wondering if this is this much lower than this.
Yeah. I think if anything, this might be here in the white deck. I have not had good experiences casting card draw spells. I'd rather just be killing my opponents.
Agree.
I think playing card draw spells is a good way to get trapped in this format. That's why I have these down here. I can see arguments for this going up, I can see arguments for these two cards going up, but this card's usually conditional on whether or not you get this guy can actually control the game to the point you want cards like this. So I'm fine with this and have bad arguments with them.
I'd move Negate up.
Negate up from just like a sideboard slot?
I'd move it into being a sideboard slot.
Okay. I have it back here just because you can just get it whenever you want it. Like, nobody wants the card's not really playable in the main deck, so you can just put it back there and you'll just get it. And you just need to realize
that it's a sideboard card. Like, I would much rather have drafted it than have drafted this guy.
I think this guy's also just a reasonable sideboard card, which at which point I think it's just a reasonable argument.
Wait, I just think Negate comes up more as the card that you'd actually bring in.
Pick an
Sure.
So, Martin, are you still, like, into the 04 guy?
04?
Give it a little more credit.
Basically, it's very low, and, like, most of us not seem to not like it, but if I just want to hear if you still
I have not seen you guys draft the blue-green deck yet. It's pretty good in the blue-green deck. It's pretty good if you use energy. It's decent in, like, any three color, like, well, basically blue green, you splash whatever. It's alright in blue red.
I would be comfortable putting Morai up as high as this, understanding that it only goes in decks that are using energy. Most often blue green, sometimes blue black.
Yeah.
So is blue green basically an energy deck still, even though there's less energy payoffs and generation?
But I'm surprised that you guys have the white Windrake so high, considering it goes into one deck, and then you have another card that goes into one of the best decks in the format, or you're like, oh yeah, this is not playable.
Which card are we getting
here? Morai.
You think the energy deck is one of the best decks in the format?
Blue green, yeah. I mean, it was in the data we got from the other camps, right?
Sure, so I guess.
That, I mean, I don't take that as gospel.
What does that mean?
You know, taking it as definitely a fact or whatever.
Okay. Well,
blue green is in the last
camp and that camp. And I think there was a lot of drafts. Like, I'm not saying it's the best archetype ever or whatever, but the green is really good. Flyers are good. You know, it has decent creatures. It's big stuff. You ramp. You have bounce spells or whatever.
So, what is blue green supposed to look like? It's just like a good stuff deck?
Mana guy. Yeah, mana guys, fed guys, splash whatever you open.
The way that I like to draft is to take the card that, you know, has the highest ceiling whenever there's a question. And I think that, like, Morai at its best is probably better than Watchful Automaton at its best. Personally, I would lay out the Morai in this category, believing that, like, it is just a fine creature. If you have, like,
blue-green with, like, big rares, basically. Like, if you have a deck that has, like, Sky Whales or the Basker, and you're just trying to, like, gum up the board and then, like, you know, maybe cast, like, this thing and some, like, use your, like, Aether Theorists to try and find your rares, like, I can believe that that's a deck that can do well and would, like, actively want Mare, whereas, like, while I've seen people play Watchful Automaton, I don't think that it's something that, like, you're ever, like, happy about. And I feel similarly about, like, Implement of Examination.
It doesn't even consider going to a GP something to brag about.
I love you guys.
Thanks, Morton.
We accept you.
All right, how about it?
I reverse these two.
Very nice.
I got you, buddy.
Which two?
Yeah,
sorry?
Controversial.
Yeah. Depends on the color pair.
I'm sliding away from that thinking.
I mean, like, these are all cards that you could potentially first pick. If my first pick is these options, I am not taking that over this. Like, I understand that, like, expensive removal is not particularly good in the format, but I still think this card is going
to
be better than that.
Being
card
able to kill
time.
Vehicles is, like, insanely important in this format, I think.
I agree with that.
Is it,
yeah.
Is still it a big game.
I think Treasure Keeper should be higher than the black category that it's beneath.
Higher than the black category? You think it should be in
you
with the Vengeful
like
Rebel?
Here?
Yes, I think it's below Vengeful Rebel,
yeah,
above,
so right here,
above those, yes.
Yeah.
I think it's like
why?
Because Fatal Push hasn't impressed me. Like, it's fine, but it's not great. Treasure Keeper's great.
Yeah,
and Gifted Aetherborn is just a very questionable first Fatal
Push. Is it the same thing as Shock, where it, like, doesn't really kill everything that you want it to, but it's
that's
so
right.
cheap that it, like, just slots in?
Yeah. It's good, but it's not amazing. And the Aetherborn is just a double black 2-drop. Like, it's hard to first pick, and I'm not taking it over Treasure Keeper. Any chance.
Isn't the Death Toucher good in exactly black blue?
It's good in black red too.
They do it in black red.
You like you like it in black red.
Yeah, so most of my black red decks want the artifact creature and they want to be able to improvise.
It's probably black white too.
I mean, how can it?
It's good in any black deck.
Okay. Yeah,
like,
see, my black red decks just have
them. Like, it has to be good in black green, right? You have multiple fight cards. Like,
not that bad.
Mine do.
No, I mean,
what?
You're 2-for-1 yourself?
Yeah, that doesn't sound good.
Why
he's
are you 2-for-1? No, I'm talking about this. Why do you?
He's talking about this.
Oh, okay.
Say the Death Toucher when we had been talking about Gifted Aetherborn,
sure.
Key, but
it's like prey upon poisoner.
Pardon me.
Yeah.
What are we talking about?
No, we're all on the same page.
That is good.
Okay.
Prey upon. We're
yes.
We're
even too. Better with Hunt the Week.
Yeah.
I think that the Scavenger should be higher. I play that guy in black, red, and black, green, and I mean, it's not like super exciting.
What's a Scavenger?
Salvager.
Oh, yeah, it's a little low.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys have it as high as here, or do you have it as high as here?
I mean, I take it over the -2/-3.
Yeah, I like it at least in the Cruel Finality pile.
I
don't think it's good for
Short
Forward.
Yeah, it's like way better than 2-3 Menace.
Like, I also have Strangler lower than that. Like, I would take
Strangler.
Either of those other
the
2-3
Menace.
The
Menace.
It goes in the same pile as a 2-2 Flyer. Like, very mediocre.
The -1/-1 to your opponent's team card is...
I would move that up again.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
It only really works in black-green. I mean, it's harder to get a +1/+1 counter out of any other color combo, really.
I mean, you obviously can just have only a black deck. Just
sure, I mean, you can do it. It's just, I have not been super stoked with this card.
I did get totally, I lost to it at AGB when someone just did it with Syndicate Trafficker in their black-white deck.
What?
This card or this card? Okay.
Wasn't this in this category before?
Yeah,
I mean,
probably.
It can move around based on the colors. But.
It should move up and
black, I just don't know why black moved it down.
Because Corey rearranged it based on how it feels.
Yeah, I think Corey just doesn't like it, and so it allowed it to fall down again.
I have not moved this card. I moved these cards up with blue.
Okay.
So this card is just sat here.
Is that where's the 5-mana sack? Did you put that in the
five mana sack in the stink bomb pile? I don't want to play.
And it's just absolutely terrible and unplayable.
I've only ever used it as a sideboard card, so I guess can mean.
I've seen some blowouts with that card before.
It is the kind of card where you will see some blowouts, like, even if it's horrible.
But does it belong in the literal garbage?
No, I think it belongs one category.
Yeah.
Sideboardable.
Right.
Or something.
Yeah, it just killed 13 power with them.
Jeez.
One of them was a Demolition Stomper, so.
Oh, wow.
How do people feel about Automaton?
Which one?
Sorry about
one mana, 1/1.
I liked it.
I think it's bad.
I don't know what to think
mediocre,
anymore.
You'll
for a lot of mixed things.
In your improvised decks.
I think it's roughly proper.
Try to avoid it otherwise.
Yeah.
I think
Black red.
I like it more than Alley Strangler.
haven't played with it that much, but I think that'd be good.
I think I'm more likely to put it in my deck than Defiant Salamander.
Have the deck.
I like Ellie Strangler more.
Sam, in your deck where you like the automaton, didn't you specifically like it with the black red guy that gives him +2/+0?
That's correct.
Okay. I've played him a bunch and haven't liked him in any other circumstance. Really, yeah. Not even good for improvise.
Okay. Yeah. Did we think the stupid Wrangle Salvager thing is good?
Yeah, that's real. That happens.
I think
it's a backdoor.
It's not exactly. It's not a. It's not plan A.
Red deck that has Wranglers. Top off your red black aggro deck with it, and it's.
I tried going super hard on it and had like six of each, and it was really bad.
No, don't do that. That's
what I'm trying. Drafting combo in limited, madness.
You're not super excited to have Salvager and black red, right? Because like red has better three drops for that deck. Like, you need like to not have got.
Yeah, but what if you have six of them?
You need to have something that's playing the wrong sense that you're putting Salvage in your deck, and then you just have also gotten the Wrangles for free.
Yeah, but Black Rod does have the like the 2/3 that also sacks, so like you have two.
Yeah, I also don't want to play that guy.
No, I know, but,
yeah, but
sometimes
saying,
you do.
Yeah, exactly. But it's like a plan C or something.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
That's
yeah.
Some,
like
multi wrong.
Like red implements and stuff like that. Like,
Manor. Red's nice.
Oh, you're talking about the Salvage. Yeah.
Scavenger.
Whatever.
Need to sell people on Chaser over.
That they can argue that. I believe they're wrong, and I'm going to keep drafting red my way. But we can move it down when everyone else wants to move it down.
No, I was more about moving Treasure Keeper and Lunge up.
Oh, there's Tangle. <Tangle. laughs>
My first observation is you're weirdly low on the 2/3 looter.
2/3
move him up like two categories.
Two categories. I'm definitely not.
There are
two
cards
categories.
Two categories ahead that I think he's better than. Like significant.
Yeah, I think that category is low.
Wait, which cards in the?
Well, there are too many cards in like the eight.
In this one.
Red is great.
I think red is just great.
I can see this
card
moving
down. Cards are all the same.
Well. Are we still doing the calling people thing?
Yeah, sure.
Okay,
exactly.
So sure. So it doesn't seem like fair. But I think this card is too high, not because it's not good, but because you don't have to take it that high.
Like, yeah. Do you think you need to pick it down here? Or do you think you need to pick it as low as here?
Probably right there.
Yeah,
like,
it just has really
like your deck wants like one of them, and like it's sorry.
No, I didn't mean to cut you off. I wanted to come in after. Good.
Oh, I think your deck wants one. Maybe people think you want two, but either way, you don't have to pick it that high, I don't think. Like, I see it going pretty late on Moto in the single limb drafts and stuff. Like, I do see it in people's decks, so it's not like people are totally sleeping on this card, but it's even if it's a similar power level up here, you don't have to pick it that high.
I'm super happy to have two. I'm willing to take it high. I made Corey second pick. I made Corey pick his second one, like, fifth in a draft. And
are you super happy to have two?
What?
Yeah.
Are you super happy to have two in like a red-white aggro deck? Or
yes.
Are you super happy to have two in like any deck?
I think it's
most red decks.
Red-blue.
Yes, not red-blue.
Some red-blue.
Red-black.
I mean, not
red-blue.
Red-black
is fantastic.
But in red-black, you end up having a lot of other cards. You have like the 4-mana removal spell, and you have like other removal spells.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't have too many non-creature cards.
I mean, the way that I draft, I take like all the good creatures over all the good removal, so I end up creature-heavy, and it's fantastic for me. I know that like Corey's been crushing people with like red black. I think that he's often had a destructive tampering or two in his deck, and I feel like they've probably been like, I haven't watched all his games, but I have a very strong suspicion that they've been a really big part of his winning.
So you're basically saying that the card is better than the removal spells in those colors.
Yes,
I think it's important enough to have the first one that in pack two, if I don't have one yet, I'm willing to take it over.
Yes,
like much higher.
That's true.
Like everything
like,
but Chaser
like,
and maybe
I'll
Chaser.
I'll take it over Shock and take it over Chaser sometimes.
Yeah.
It just like you.
Yeah, not having one.
Not having one in red
is atrocious.
It's much well. It's just much worse than having one.
Yeah.
But also, I think I am with Rich on the looter. Like I think it's just so good because I mean I just want it in every deck that has vehicles in red.
I think looter is better than removal, certainly. Like I have, I think it's like on par with Chaser.
I strongly disagree with that. Chaser's just not really replaceable. It's a 2-drop that makes an artifact for improvise. It plays exceptionally well with combat tricks. It gets the evasive guys rolling much more quickly. Whereas the 2/3 doesn't really man any of the good vehicles on his own. He still needs a buddy. Yes, he's a good card. I'm still going to be very happy to have him, but I'm not going to be first picking him like I am Chaser. I'm going to be taking him in third, fourth, though.
So you're improvising? I think that's totally reasonable.
Yeah, but are you just like, you just know you're going to be improvising versus taking like the objectively, like the
well,
objectively
saying,
better
like,
card? Or?
Well, okay, so the problem with this guy is that like my red decks are leaning really hard on Crusher.
Okay.
And so I don't like playing a guy that's not going to be able to crew it.
Sure.
Like it's so easy to get 3-power 3-drops. that I feel like I'm going to be able to just have like all of my three drops be three power guys.
Okay.
And so like having a two power three drop is kind of awkward there. And so he's in a really weird spot where he wants you to have vehicles, but he's the wrong guy to have with the vehicles unless you like get freighters and stuff.
Sure.
So, I mean, like, certainly if I open this, then I'm taking this guy way over this.
Sure.
Because I have a good thing to crew with it. But it's pretty awkward to set yourself in a situation where you have to be crewing with this and someone else.
Right, like, I think he just generally doesn't align with Sam's draft strategy. Like, if you're taking Falter really high, then that guy's less good, whereas if you're taking Removal, he becomes really good.
Yeah. You just want to be killing their blockers and looting and finding more removal.
Yeah.
I think Hungry Flames should probably be a category up, and I kind of wonder if the Double Strike guy should be a category down.
Agreed.
Does everybody take either Chaser over Hungry Flames? Let's say it's first big, first bag, there's no much else.
I guarantee you that not everyone does that.
Well, no, I mean, here, like,
I take either Chaser over Hungry Flames, yes.
I would probably take Hungry Flames.
I would take Hungry Flames.
So how many Hungry Flames? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Don't know. Okay.
I mean,
how many chasers?
So then,
1, 2, 3, 4. So it's like pretty five. So it's pretty even.
Well, what do you like?
It's five.
So you
shall we?
More?
Should we talk
well,
about
I'm just
this
surprised
more?
That we have like six people doing this and six people doing that. Like it has to be one or the other, right?
Yeah.
But well, we don't have to be able to figure it out.
I don't know.
He just got really amped up of the Windrake versus Moray, so he's trying to recreate that. Martin,
I think there comes a point where like you have enough. Like you have a low enough curve in pack two where you could consider taking like I would take the removal spell at that point, but I think it's just more important to have
two drops
covered as far as two drops first, and that is like the best.
Okay, I agree that the two drop is really good and it's hard to replace it because like making the artifact the artifact token is really good for your improvised stuff, but
I just want my curve to be a bigger consideration than like some of the removal spell, even if it's a good one. Because especially in a format with folders,
you can
pick
up big guys
aren't
that bad.
Yeah.
And again, there aren't that
many. With tampering.
Yes, there are.
There aren't.
You get red five drops for free in pack three.
So I like the giant.
I mean, Wayward Giant is a lot better.
Down one
category,
I think. I like it a lot, but like this category is still super good.
Don't necessarily.
I mean, I think that red's just like
I agree with that.
Being
vulnerable to artifact removal is not nothing.
Okay.
So we are taking Sweatworks Brawler over in Rage Knight, even in the heavy improvised decks.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yep.
I was personally picking in this category Brawler over this, but I didn't know if everybody was in that group.
Okay. I'm open to the idea that this should maybe be up here, but I'm not sure.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Those are the two categories I had it between. I eventually just threw it in this pile as I put it in one deck and it was bad.
So the more of this and this you have, the better it is by quite a bit.
Yeah.
Sure.
And outside of that, like, I've played it primarily in red-green, where I have big guys and giving trample is just like...
I've had it in red-white and red-green, it's been great.
Yeah, Rich described it as a more versatile lava axe. Like, it's pretty easy to get 5 damage out of it, and sometimes it's like, trades a guy and gets a bunch of damage through or whatever.
This is big time ever.
Like I said,
horses.
People have a lot of qualms in the way that I rank green, and this is why I don't end up green much, and I don't believe green's the best color.
Oh, we've got some qualms.
And go.
Matt, did you
want to for starters, I think Druid does not belong in the category that it's in.
Down here.
Where's Leopard?
Where's Leopard?
Leopard's,
Leopard's here.
Oh my god.
I don't like Leopard much. Right.
I think I would pick that over Calibrate.
Well, I just think the water is not really that good. Like, I don't think he really does very much for you.
Yeah, I think Drew's down a category.
Yeah.
I think that, like,
strong
the
disagree.
+3/+3 thing is higher than all the cards he's with right now.
+3/+3.
You think this is higher than all the cards it's with?
I actually like those uncommons.
Yeah, it's definitely higher.
I think it moves down in green.
Not in green.
I think in green this moves down. This can stay.
No, I was talking about the green uncommons.
Okay. Yeah,
what's
so you can move that.
You can go down.
What's the one underneath the
2/3?
It's the energy guy.
The energy lore guy.
I've never played with that.
It's been
decent.
It's been fine.
It's decent.
Okay. I think that the I think the pump spell is better than the category you have it in, but it's probably worse than the next category up. So maybe I would just move the other curves down. I don't really know. I think Unbridled Growth is
too low.
You have it way too low.
Yep.
It's like an important revolt enabler for this. The 5 mana 6/6 is truly a 5 mana 6/6 if you have that in your deck, and it's a totally reasonable card.
You think this is in this pile?
I take it over Druid.
I think it's better than this pile.
So you're saying it's this and this.
Yeah, that's more like it.
You're just losing your shit about this Druid.
You guys can do what you want. I'm just,
well, so
I just don't have
green. Let's just pause for a second. Why do you like the Druid so much?
Because it fights reasonably well, and it accelerates you.
It
does what it says it does.
I know, but what is it?
The 5 drops. It
eels.
Eel, I was kidding.
Go 5s. It blocks all your guys, either chasers and everything. Like, I'm always in a spot where I play my 2-1, they play a druid, and I'm like, well, I can't attack anymore. I can take my guy that I needed for improvise. Like, it's not a bad card.
I didn't think it's a bad card.
There's kind of the combination. Like, because I like druid, my green decks are more mana hungry. So, like, I'm playing multiple 5 drops.
So,
I don't know. Yes. I don't understand how you make successful mana hungry green decks in this form. There's just so few big guys. Like, I never have enough top end if I have druids in my deck to, like, make them worthwhile.
I think the issue that we had with druid was that people were playing it trying to ramp into something on 4, and that something on 4 was still smaller than a crusher. And, like,
well,
we can play crusher.
It was, like, half the size of a crusher.
So, yeah. So, like, it just. The plan of playing a druid to get a turn ahead was not as good as just playing out a curve. And then, like, crushing.
The problem is, in every color, there are more good 3 drops than 4 drops. Like, every color is basically low on good force. And so it's really hard to have a, like, curve this druid friendly. And it doesn't, like, punish your opponent for having a slow start in any way. Like, it's in terms of just being 1-3. Like, basically,
well, it does. Like, it's providing mana. Mm-hmm. It's still providing mana.
No, but that, like, it often...
It doesn't convert into anything, is what he's saying.
I'm saying, like... You like a majority of the time that I see people cast that on turn 2, they cast a 3-drop on turn 3, and so it's not actually like pressure.
That's fine if the next turn you get a double spell or play a 5-drop though.
If you get to do that, yes. But I'm saying like a large portion of the game where that's in your opening hand, I think that it taps for mana once or twice over the course of the game.
Also, the big 5-drops don't benefit from being accelerated out too. It's like Eagle, Cavalry, like they need to be set up, not accelerated.
It's also good at blocking, like good against their good draws.
I agree that, like, if I have a deck with a ton of late game, it's a fine, like, Lumen Grid Warden. But I think that it's, like, not a lot better than that, and really bad if you're, like, trying to, like, curve out an attack.
I guess I'm kind of in between you guys. Like, I don't pick it that high, but I mean, obviously you could just have decks where you want it. You just, like, pick expensive
cards. So maybe here?
Yeah, like, there's no way I'm taking Giant Growth over.
I agree with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a different question. Does everybody agree green is the best color?
No.
Red.
Green's
I think red is by far the best color.
Third or fourth.
I believe that you get tricked by the green on commons. I don't like most of the green commons, to be fair. After about these two, I'm... Whatever, and I'm not really high on this card.
No,
I'm higher on this card than this card, personally.
I agree with that. I think the 5 and 6-6 is total gas.
Yeah.
It's much better than that leopard.
Didn't we have the highest win rate with green?
I don't know.
Thought we did.
I think Justin was the one who looked into the numbers.
I'm not saying we shouldn't look at that stuff, but it's also like early drafts in the format.
Yeah, that's fair.
You didn't have like our own data, did we?
No.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Oh, okay, I guess you were just looking at
the other stuff.
Well,
yeah.
I mean, it was ones that we participated in, at least some of us, so it's not.
Like, yeah.
Green is just a good color to be.
It's just
it
like
goes
seems
well
kind
of
deep.
It goes well with black. It goes well with blue. I'm not saying it should be green white, but. It's just a good color to be in.
So yeah. Once you know how to draft the blue-green energy deck that Martin's talking about that
right.
we don't really draft, then I agree that green
right.
is one of the best colors to be
yeah.
in. But if you don't know...
Red is just literally good with every other color right. and has
red's
really cards overall.
Yeah, like red white is good and green white is not.
Like, it just sounds like Martin's drafting this deck much different, right? Like, you're taking Druid higher, and you're just, like, being a traditional, like, energy deck. And
I agree.
You're, like, a mid-range control deck.
Yeah.
And just when I draft green, I'm trying to draft an aggressive deck with giant smashers.
Oh, okay. Sure. When I draft green, I just want to be, like, big stuff. I just want to have big guys.
Dinosaurs.
And, like, that's also where, like, Prey Upon is decent. And, like, you just have a lot of cards that nobody wants to take. You get them late, and you just play a bunch of big guys, and...
Sure.
It's like your normal draft deck from a normal draft format. Which bunch of big guys? Didn't we just say like you can just play the red 5-drop, like the 5-mana 5/4. Like nobody's gonna take it from you. You're gonna get it in the last 2 cards. It's a decent card. You just play it on turn 4. It turns on your prey upons. It turns on other cards. It's a fine deck. It's like a normal deck from normal draft formats.
Yeah, I don't want to have to plan to play a 5-4-4-5. Like, I'll put it in my deck if I have to, but I'm not
saying you should take it high. Like, we just said, like, there's a million fives. It's a
ridiculous. No, you're saying you don't have to, like, pick it. You'll get it for free, and then you'll put it in your deck and your deck. Justin's saying he doesn't want his plan to be to get it for free and to play it. He wants to, like, get enough good cards that he doesn't want to play it.
I'm also not saying you should play that 5-4. Like, there's other 5 drops.
But you can get a 4.
My point is that there's not a lot of good top end that I want. There's so much less of it than I'm used to. This is why I'm down in the mana guy. It's like, this is why I'm down in Prey Upon. It's the same thing. Like, the big guys, like, you have to play either, you have to pick them high and play worse ones than you would have in any other format to get the same results.
Corey? In your theoretical energy deck, is this a playable magic?
It is a playable card.
Okay. So do you have this up in this category where I have, like, Cyborg category, or is it like the Mobile Garrison category?
We've had a bunch of green black and green blue energy decks that played multiples of this card.
Interesting.
Three O's. I think I posted pictures of that in the forum.
Okay, I'll have to go back and look. So where are you guys taking this? Are you guys taking this, like, Mobile Garrison, like, 8th pick category? Or are you taking it, like, the old, like, 9 through 12?
It depends, obviously, on what you have. Also, like, you just get this card, like, super late, and then nobody's going to take it from you. Yeah. You take a 9th pick or whatever.
Okay, so I'll put it in this category for now.
So you just get all the free Moray Eels and Peace Walkers, and then bam, just all the energy.
What's the most common route into the energy deck? What am I getting in the first pack that I'm gonna be? What's the most common way to come out of the first pack setting up to be green blue energy?
I think it's like opening one of the blue, like, rares. Kind of
leave aside the rares.
Something big. Yeah, I mean.
But that might be a high.
If you can.
I also have the same pick as you guys. I take, like, the red cards over these cards unless I open the Gearhulk or whatever.
Yeah.
But if I open, like, some of the big uncommons, rares, whatever, like the flying guys that make energy, like, you bounce them in your hand or whatever. Like, I don't know the names, but then
the whale.
Yeah, something like that. Like, cards like that. Then this is what I want to be drafting. Yeah.
Basically, specifically Basker or Whale or Gearhulk.
Yeah, like, it's also, this deck is also really good at splashing, so, like, if people are passing around, like, the white, blue, 4 mana, 3-2 guy, tap something, like, you can splash for those kind of cards in your green and blue deck.
So, sorry, are we done talking about that? What do people take here?
Ooh. We'll discuss that in the overall here in a minute.
We'll discuss it right now.
Yeah,
it's not green.
I'm on train.
I'm also training.
Train. It's a colorless card.
Yeah, it's colorless, yes. And also I think I've seen it win more often when cast than the 5.
If you're always gonna play it, it's a great card. The other card you can take and then not play it in your deck, you're gonna be very, very unhappy that you took a card that's on the same power level, but it cannot make your deck.
We all agree that if you are green, you do take the Gearhulk, right? Like,
so
it is a better, more powerful card.
If you're pretty sure you're going to be in green, you would just take Dusker over.
But it's close.
Yeah.
But it's close enough that
yeah.
at least most people think
yeah.
that the artifact makes a difference.
Agreed.
Yeah.
It also turns on some synergies and things like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, if you already have, like, a Constrictor, then it's like.
Hey, they're both good.
They're both
good.
Constrictors.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
All
right.
Okay. Both the regular? Or do you think these two move down to this category?
No, because I think those. I mean, I might move the Rogue Refiner up the category.
And maybe the Boar too.
Rogue Refiner and the Boar. The other gold cards, the bottom gold cards, I think they're about as good.
I mean,
as
I think I'm pretty unlikely to first pick a gold card besides Constrictor.
Yeah.
That's just.
I'm most likely to.
Again, these are biases against green for me. I don't end up green. I don't win with green, so I'm not picking green gold cards. If people think they're higher, I'm fine moving them up. But
I'm guessing you're into Rogue Refiner.
Yeah, I also like the green 4-4. The red green 4-4.
Oh, yeah. No, it's quite good.
It's
good.
Yeah. I mean, we're talking about pick one, pack one.
Yeah. Spire Patrol is the only gold card I'm considering first picking other than this thing.
The Boar is a good card to land where else in, too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do we need to move any of these around? We're arguing for spreading these categories out further, like, where we actually pick order in these, we figure out which colors we actually think is stronger. It sounds like people either think red or green is the best, and we should probably try to
I
want to
kind of sort this out.
Yes, exactly. This is the category I really want to figure out, and this category I really want to figure out.
Do you take Jundras, Revolution, or...
Shock?
If you were so low in Fatal Push, you take that or Fatal Push?
I'm not low on Fatal Push. My pick order out of just the red stuff is Champion Chaser or Chaser Champion. I'm not sure on which one yet. Flames Revolution Brawler Shock.
Yeah, but what about compared to Fatal Push?
Compared to Fatal Push, I have Fatal Push below Chaser Champion Aetherborn, but above Hungering Flames.
Hold on, I'd like to pull the room on Hungry Flames versus Double Strike for your up. Who prefer? Strike. Raise your hand if you prefer Double Strike.
I don't know what I prefer.
Raise your hand if you prefer Hungry Flames.
I guess Hungry Flames. I don't know.
I haven't made my decision.
All right, I split the room.
The champion's like pretty absurd, but it does feel really bad and get shocked or whatever. Like,
but like it's a four drop, and by that time they had a chance to shock your two other creatures, so.
Yeah, I mean, so four or five. You just feel bad if you die exactly to shock.
I mean,
like if they use like a daring demolition or whatever on it, you're fine with that, or
my experience.
Well, I'm like cheap removal that normally wouldn't kill your four drop. So like Chandra's Fire, you look
sure. Cruel Finality,
the two to two things.
Okay.
Like, yeah, I don't mean literally shock. I mean things that normally like have to like kill the cheaper shit. Like,
okay.
My experience with that card is that I play it and. If I have some stupid way to get it through, like a falter or the +2/+2 flying thing.
Or it's like attacking with it. I don't know. I don't really
attacking with it just trades for a guy a lot of times, is what I'm saying. It's the second time.
I haven't had that experience with it.
3/3 first strike? Like, what do they have that just trades with it?
I mean,
they have to have like a lot of.
That's the issue.
Either trades with a spell or a creature, or if he doesn't and I have a way to get it through, I win the game on the spot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like, the upside is very huge,
and it makes things like aerial modification really good. And falter.
I like winning games.
Yeah. They're not losing.
Yeah, I think I would move Hungry Flames out of the category.
Okay.
I guess it was
like the best card in the category.
I think it's probably the best card in this category.
Yeah, sure.
Does everyone have it below all the other cards in this category?
Well, I mean, we just disagreed about champion. But
yeah.
No, I'd probably take it over the black cards. I don't like black.
Okay.
So I want to get people's opinion on where they rank Snake compared to like the rest of the cards that are in this deck.
Do you want to try splitting this into two piles, Corey, and see how successful it goes?
I take Snake over Passive Pain.
It's going to be dangerous.
Yeah, people are going to get pissed.
Oh, God, the black card's one of the
top ones. We're dead.
You guys are all dead, like I said.
Pacific Array or Snake?
I don't think it's close. I would take Array. I'd take Array.
Me too.
Green guy, too.
Yeah, I've had some bad experiences.
You would take Array over Tusker?
This green guy?
Wow.
Damn.
Strong statement.
Really? No, I don't do that.
Would you take?
That's crazy.
Would you take Snake or Vengeful Rebel?
Rebel.
So you like the safer?
Yeah, I don't like the gold cards first.
Maybe it might just be that I just like Snake more than I should.
It's a great card.
Obviously, this is still pretty high, and like, I think I'm way more inclined to pick this than almost any gold uncommon I can think of, like in the past or whatever. Just it's like so important to the deck, like as far as picking high.
But, so if we had to rank the cards that are currently in the same category as Snake, where would the other people have it?
They're all worse than Snake.
Yeah, I think Snake's much higher.
So then, is it in the conversation with Vengeful, or is it just like notched by it that it should be just at the top of the list there where it is?
So time out. Everyone is currently taking Snake over these other five cards.
I would.
Okay, I'm taking Snake 5th out of 6 in this pile.
Okay.
What about you, Richie?
You said before you don't like green.
Sounds like we need to move Snake up a category.
Okay, so you guys want to move Snake up here.
Yeah. Not in that category, below that category. It's
so you think there's another category that is right here?
Yes, exactly.
The more categories we have,
the better we'll do it.
That's basically it. It's just such a highest ceiling if you get that card distracted around it.
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised at how high the Revolutionary is.
The card's really been solid for me.
Which card?
The Revolutionary. The 3/3.
ETB dies.
Oh, that guy's really good.
I
just
turn
Bandar into that guy and you're...
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
It's just not hard to do at all.
Sure. It seems like enough for the time that it'll just be like that its ability won't be relevant.
It'll just be a 3/3 trampler.
I've also
for
been
three.
I've also been happy playing it on 4 as it plays with like Team Outrider. If you play it on 5, Thriving Rhino, if you attack with
it. I think trying to differentiate this.
Yeah, we need to differentiate this pile also.
Yes, I agree.
So do you want to just separate that, take a photo of that, and then we can move on to the next one?
Sure.
So it's not too.
It can give you an energy.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I mean, it does a lot of stuff.
I'm curious about Rich's pick order. Out of all these cards.
Do you take the...
I guess.
We're on to the best card. So I put the Oblivion Ring above the two black cards there. Probably above the green card, too. So I can move Oblivion Ring up a category to start with.
You'd have O-Ring up a category?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're still working on this. We're not doing this nonsense.
Right. No,
okay.
Yep. So I guess I'd put it in with the snake.
You'd have this even up a second pile.
Yeah. I have it ahead of those cards. That's just like a preference thing.
Reasonable. Whatever.
Then what else do you want me to do? Like,
do you want
anything else?
Anything else you'd move?
Do you want me to rank like those four?
Sure, if you want to, go for it.
Whatever
you want.
Provide is desired.
Okay.
I guess I would put over Tusker, right?
Yes, yeah, so that I do like that. I put so red 2-drop, red 4-drop, green card, and then the black cards in order. So if we're gonna make them descending, yeah, like that.
This.
Yeah.
So,
which black card is higher?
Probably Fatal Push. Next category looks. I'd probably take red card, colorless card, blue card, green card. And we're expanding. I'm sure there's a bunch of things I'd want to do here.
We haven't even expanded this yet.
For the Aetherborn, if black is bad, is it relevant that it's double black? Like, you don't want to. You're probably not going to end
it's
up in a Tesla swamp deck.
Yeah, I don't think black is bad, but.
Or if black is shallow,
black is,
whatever.
I mean, even if black's your support color, you're still probably playing the 4-mana removal spell. That's
Rich, did you have this
so
or
you
this
have
first?
To play a bunch of
you're just gonna end up playing like.
If I open those two, I would probably take Oblivion Ring.
But you're still Freighter 2.0 over Pass Station.
Yeah.
So this is the Rich pick order.
Is it green guy or?
Oh, we gotta get this on the top
for
sure.
Is it Rich Owen?